When you install Windows on a computer, I can't open this box, come on. Ah, there we go, it opens from the side. This is empty. I'll be right back. Okay, when you install Windows on a computer, you install it on something like this, a hard drive, right? But the fun part is also on the same hard drive as everything else you put on it. So your pictures, your videos, your documents, you're sharing this hard drive with your Windows operating system. So in this video, this episode, we're going to explore where is Windows on your hard drive? And this is crazy important because as someone learning Windows, you might have to go in there and do a few things. And you gotta be familiar with where things are at. And also, if you're learning hacking or trying to protect yourself from being hacked, knowing what hackers are targeting is a pretty good thing to know. So let's dive in. So here we are in Windows land, and I want you to follow along with me. So if you have your copy of Windows or your current laptop or whatever you have, follow along, let's do this. We're gonna start out in the Windows Explorer, probably the most used Windows application. We'll just search for Windows Explorer because for some reason mine isn't saved to my taskbar. That's so weird. And it's called File Explorer officially. Let's open it. Now, as you probably guessed, your File Explorer is what you can use to explore all of your files. You probably use this quite a bit. And then notice by default, it just kind of kicks you to this home area and you have a bunch of quick access things. Now, I personally don't like that. In fact, that's one of the first things I change when I get my Explorer set up. And I found this recently, actually. If you click on the little dot icons here. This is a little quick tech tip here. Eat your heart out, Linus. We'll go to options. And right here where it says open File Explorer 2, we'll change that from home. You don't have to change this. Change it from home to this PC. And I'll show you why in a second because we're about to go there anyway. And it's the first place I always go to when I open up Explorer. So we'll click apply and okay. So now I'm gonna close Explorer. Actually, I'm gonna pin this to my taskbar. You would have learned this in a previous episode if you didn't already know that. That way when I close it, it's still right there for me to access right now. Here we go. And bam, it's now on this PC right here. And notice going to this PC shows us our devices and our drives. So if you still use DVDs, there's a DVD drive. All right, I'm gonna look at that right now. But if you were to insert a flash drive, or you had a network share, it would show up here. That's why I love going to this PC because that's, I mean, if you look at my computer here, this is my computer. This PC is where I have all of my network locations. So when I'm getting to video editing projects and things, they're right there. But the main part of the story I wanna point out is your C drive. Notice it's called Windows because that's where Windows is installed. Now I've done nothing to this computer. This is a fresh installation from Azure. It has 109 gigabytes free of 126 gigabytes. That means the rest of that, that little blue stuff, that's all Windows, man. That's what Windows is taking up. Now also one more thing I want to point out is notice it is labeled as your C drive. 9 times out of 10, probably 10 times out of 10, except for the very rare exception, Windows will be installed on the C drive. And that's just a letter assigned to a drive. Notice we have our D drive over here. We have our E drive over here. Now let's stop talking about it. Let's double click the Windows C drive and jump in there. We're in. Now at first glance, it's like fun. Not a lot going on here. But there's actually a ton going on here. I'm gonna cover a few of these real quick, and then I'll show you the hidden files that you can't even see right now. That's right, there's hidden stuff. I'll show you. The first thing I wanna point out is the users folder, or users directory. This is where it stores all the information about users, as you might expect. So right now, I am the NetworkChuck user. So I bet you a box of donuts that if you opened up that user folder, you would see a user named NetworkChuck, with folders and desktop stuff and everything. Same for you. What do you say we try it out? Let's open it up. Users, wouldn't you know, there I am right there. If I jump in there, go ahead and click on yours too. It looks a lot like my left sidebar because it is. These are just shortcuts to this location. Oh, by the way, notice up here, I know if you're new to Windows, this may not be intuitive, but you get breadcrumbs at the top here. So you can just jump back and forth. My daughter's kind of struggle with that idea. So I can click on users and just go back one directory. So when you add a new user, it's gonna show up here with all their own stuff. Now it's important to note that as a user, you only have access to your user folder. So if there were another user, Bernard Hackwell, I wouldn't have permissions to open that folder. Now you're probably going, Chuck, what do you mean permission? We're gonna talk about that in the next episode, but I just wouldn't be able to open it, which is kind of a good thing. You wouldn't want, you know, your friend or buddy or mom or whoever opening up your stuff. Now on the other hand, the public folder right here, this public user, like who's public? This is by default created and it's accessible to everybody. So if you wanted to add a file for your friend to find, that might be where you put it. So that's the users folder. If we step back, we'll get back to our C drive. Two very important directories that you'll probably use all the time are the program files. Now notice we have two here. We have program files x86 and program files without anything, so he's not as cool. Now the reason we have two is the difference in the applications you might be able to install. And to explain that, it requires a bit of a little history lesson. So right now, you can actually do this too. If you right-click this PC, you can show properties about your system. And right here, under device specifications, I see a thing called system type. And it tells me this is a 64-bit operating system with an X64-based processor. What does that mean? We're not gonna go into that. But just know, this wasn't always the case. For a long time, we only had 32-bit operating systems. Now, the main difference between 32 and 64 is that 64 can do more and do it faster. So what that means is people can create 64-bit applications, which will use more resources and go faster. They can do more things. But people can also still create 32-bit applications. So here's the point. When you see program files, that's where our 64-bit apps are stored. When you see x86 program files, that's where our 32-bit apps are stored. Now, if you just had a 32-bit operating system, you may have that, you would only see one program files. You wouldn't have an x86. But because this is a 64-bit operating system, you got two folders. Now, right now, this system I have doesn't have a ton of applications I've installed. But what might be fun for you is if you have one that does, you can jump into these program files and see like what applications are installed that are 64 and that aren't 64-bit. But you'll notice here that Windows will give you a 64-bit version of, like, let's say Windows Media Player. They'll also give you a 32-bit version of Windows Media Player. And inside these folders is everything these applications need to run. Now, for example, if I jump into this Windows Media folder, I'll find the actual application icon to launch it. Man, I haven't launched this in a long time. It looks really old. Oh, it's the legacy version. That's fun. So it's a burn option. My gosh. Now, one thing I want to try is I want to try and install an application real quick. Let's go install Google Chrome. And we'll see what folder it goes to. And it's kind of giving it away though. It says for Windows 10, 11, 64-bit, we're installing the 64-bit version of this application. And this might be like a light bulb moment for some of you, because you'll see that when you go to download certain applications for your computer, it'll say, do you want 32 or 64? Most of the time, if you're running a 64-bit OS, you want 64, it'll run better. Okay, Chrome is installed. Let's go see where it is. Bet you a box of donuts will be in program files. And there it is. Often you'll see it installed in like an author folder. So here it'll be Google. If I jump into Google, there's Chrome, there's the application, and there's all the stuff. And then there's the actual application itself. Perf logs will store some Windows performance logs. Azure will not be common to everyone because I'm running an Azure machine. So we'll ignore that for now. You may also not see packages. And then now onto the last guy we can see, the Windows folder. Now, wild guess, what do you think is stored here? Windows. The Windows operating system is in this folder. Let's jump in there. Let's go. Crazy world. Lots of weird folders. That's all you're gonna pretty much see. And that's most of, like, if you scroll down, like, there's a lot going on here. Oh my goodness. And a lot of stuff you'll probably never ever want to touch. Unless you're an admin and you're learning, you know what you're doing, which you're about to be doing that. Now, there is a special folder that is so special, I have to point it out. Amongst all these folders, this is the guy that shines. Let me show you. If you scroll down to the S's, it's alphabetical order here. We've got the System 32 folder. This folder is super important. Let's jump in there. This is where all the core things are stored that Windows needs to run, the System 32 folder. So if you delete this, you dead. I mean, look at all these things. You'll notice a lot of files with the .dll extension, but all you need to know about this folder right now is that there's a lot of important things here, and we're gonna carefully back out. Don't blow anything up. Another folder that's also pretty fun and doing the same thing, I love the way it's named, the SysWow 64. Looks very similar and has a lot of the same type of core features your system needs to run. Again, don't break anything. Another notable one will be the WinSXS. That is so hard to say. This directory contains components, updates, and service packs. Copy of them anyway. It's the Windows Component Store. Not like a store you buy things, like a storage area. So that's the Windows folder. That's where Windows is installed. I know, that was amazing, right? So let's back up just a little bit, get back to our C drive. Now let's talk about the hidden stuff you can't see. How do we see it? Let's change that. Let's take off the blindfold. We're gonna go up here to see more, these little three dots. And we're gonna click on Options. Then we'll click on View. And right here, you'll see a little, it's really small. It says Hidden Files and Folders. Right now it's defaulted to Don't Show Hidden Files, Folders, or Drives. Let's click on Show. We wanna see them. Click that, apply it. Okay, whoa. There's some hidden stuff you didn't even know about. Now, we're not gonna cover everything, but I do wanna point out a few of the hidden folders, and really one just popped up in your drive. So if we go to our users directory and we jump into NetworkChuck, now notice there's a new default one. what is this? This is actually a template for how to create a new user. So when a new user is created, it's gonna have all of these folders created for them. So we didn't see that before, it's kind of fun. Now jumping into your directory, me, I'm NetworkChuck. Notice I have an app data folder now. What is this? This is application data specific to me. So if I configure an application to be a certain way, it'll store those settings in the app data settings, and it's just stored for me. So if Bernard logs in, he'll have different settings. And so think about like my Chrome browser, if I have bookmarks and all these different things, Chrome would store that information in my app data folder and it's only my stuff. So a common thing you might do as an admin is you might go into the local low or roaming directories and delete data. Like let's go to local here, Google. You might delete this. I'll just do it right now. Actually, I'll go back here to local and delete Google completely. You might delete that to clear out the user's configured settings because something might have broken, and then Google, when you launch it again, will automatically create it. It's a very common thing I've done throughout my help desk years. See, bam, it just created the directory again. Did you see that? It's like a magic trick. Now you just saw a glimpse, a hidden world of Windows, where it's installed, where your stuff might be. But did you know that you can navigate all of this from the command line? Think MS-DOS. But you'll look like a boss. I just had to rhyme with that. I'm gonna show you a few tricks of how you can navigate around the command line, specifically PowerShell, in the next episode. It'll be quick, it'll be fun. I'll see you there.
It's me, NetworkChuck from the future.
Just kidding,
it's me, Alex.
If you wanna see tons more great IT courses just like this one, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.